स्टैंडर्ड 10 सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस एंड एज यू नो दैट वी आर डिस्कशन अबाउट चैप्टर नंबर 15 इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट. बिफोर एक्सप्लोर टुडेज टॉपिक जस्ट टेक अ ग्लांस ऑन द रिवीजन पार्ट एंड यू कैन से व्हाट वी हैव डन इन द लास्ट वीडियो. इट मींस इट इज कॉल्ड रीकैप. जस्ट क्विकली वी कॉल अबाउट वी जस्ट डिस्कस अबाउट दिस रीकैप. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इन यस्टरडेज और यू कैन से लास्ट वीडियो वी टॉक अबाउट दैट अ टू क्वेश्चन आंसर. That is the factor of production of 2 marks and distribution of factor of production that we have discussed. Now, factor of production. You know that there are 4 factors of production: land, capital, labor, and entrepreneurship. Now, you know that in the production system, all these factors are too much important. For example, land. First, we discuss about the land. In land, we know that land, actually, in the general term, we can say land is the uppermost surface of the earth. But in terms of economics, land is called the natural resource or the things which is available in our surrounding. For example, forest, river, valleys, mountains, etc. This is called or types of land. Even the minerals which is available in the interior of the earth, these all are included in land. And that is why the land is also called the natural tool for the production. Then after we talk about that, second factor is capital. In capital is called the man-made resource that includes the instruments, investments, property, assets, houses, premises where the production is going to be done. These all things are included in capital. Then after we talk about the labor, you know that from that we have made two question answer or two objectives. Labor is the mental and physical work which is done to gain the monetary resource. It means we know that labor is the living factor of production. The work of teachers, doctors, artisans, farmers, these all are included in the part of this labor. And the last and most important is entrepreneurship. What is entrepreneurship? Yesterday, last week also I talked about that. The you can say collaboration of these three, you can say these factors of these three factors, collaborations, it is called entrepreneurship. In Gujarat, it is called Ayojan, Niyojan or planning. That is also must be a perfect. Then after second question, we talk about the distribution of resources. In that we have talked about that, you know that wants are unlimited, human wants are unlimited, but to fulfill them the resources are limited. That we have discussed. In second term is that important order is necessities. It means that we know that we have the list of wants, but we must have to be give the important order which wants are fulfilled first and later on others. Third one is that limited resources. You know that to fulfill our wants, the resources as well as natural as well as man, but both are, you can say that limited quantity. So we need to use the resources in judicious way. And the last one is that alternative use of these resources. Now, alternative means what that? For example, if we have used the one resource and that resource should be used another way, it is called multiple usage. Alternate means what? Instead of this resource, we can use another resource. In that, I have given the example of piece of land. If I have a piece of land, if I have shown the wheat, then the thing of a bajra wheat or you can say other crops should not be necessary. Because this land is already occupied, you can say that properly filled. So apart from this, another two question answer that is too small, short. From that only we have discussed land is the factor of production. Okay, so you can write about these questions only from that last question. And the another question is that human wants are unlimited. From one wants, another wants is originated. We give a priority to the important wants, which basic wants fulfilled first. That for example, food, clothes and shelter. These all things we have discussed yesterday. Now, students, now today we will explore our this next topic, today's topic we can say that, and it is methods of allotting of resources. Now, students, before we start this topic, please remember that methods of allocating of resources. Now, what is the method? Understood? It is the most important and it is quite, you can say, difficult also. And board examinations, it must ask, it is because it is the second phase of the chapter. You know that the chapter is divided into two parts, one and two. So we have completed the first part. Now onwards, whatever we discuss, it is the second part of the chapter. So you must watch the video carefully. Okay. Now methods of allocating of resources. Now what is the method? It is most important. And what is the allocating of resources? That is also we need to understand. So first of all, each and every country in the entire world wants to be economically developed, but this development, for this development, they require resources, and how these resources should be allotted. So that is why there are total two methods in the entire world to you can say for the economic development, and these are market system and second one is socialist system. Now you just see students, market system and socialist system, but today in today's video we'll complete the entire market system, because from the market system there will be four questions will be there. For example, write a short note on market system. What are the features of the market system? Okay, what are the benefits of the market system, and what are the disadvantages of the market system? So all these four questions we will discuss today, so we are able to understand. And then today, or you can say day after these videos, we'll having the another system, or you can say socialist system. So let explore today's video with the market system. Now first of all, we need to take a market system. What is market system? So first of all, we'll discuss. You can say before that we can write about the short note of market system. For example, I will change this market system and I will write the questions. Today's first question: write a note on market system. It may be asked for 2 marks only. Now just see that both market system and socialist system, they are exactly opposite of each other, we can say. What? They are exactly opposite of each other. So first point we'll write about that: opposite of each other. Now you just see that whatever the features, or you can say advantages, disadvantages of market system, if you get the market system, exactly you are getting the socialist system. But if you have any difficulties to understanding the market system, then quite difficult to understand socialist system, because these both are exactly opposite. So if you get the knowledge about the first, then completely you will be getting second also automatically, we can say. It's a one kind of difference. Understood? So now first one that we have written, opposite of each other. Now except, or you can say the nations like America and Japan, they are economically developed through the market system. So we'll write another one is that America and Japan economically develop through this only market system. Apart from this, we can say that what is market system? So market system is also called capitalist system. You just see that I will write only main words or keywords of the answer, so you can explore these statements while you are writing the answer. Why it is called capitalist system? Because here, wherever the production is done, the owner is, you can say, free to increase its production. That is why it is called capitalist system. Understood? And most important thing that we are going to discuss is that profit scope. Understood? For example, I will tell you, what is the profit scope? For example, I will be having one factory. Understood? So I will be having the rights to how much production is going to be done for this month or for this day. Okay. So here I get the freedom. That is why it is called capitalist system. So for the production purpose, what is my main goal or aim? I know that my main aim or goal is that profit scope. It means this activity or this system is generally focused on the profit only. We can say that. Now, second thing is that in the production system, the profit is at the center. What you can say? Profit is at the center. Now, you know that why the profit is at the center? Because if my factory is there, so what should I decide or what should I do? It means, for example, if I will produce something, for example, if I am producing the watch, understood? I will be having the factory or industry of to making the watch. So what is my first aim or goal? To earn the huge amount of profit. That is the center. So in market system, it is most important that profit is at the center. So I will tell in little also, in socialist system, social welfare is at the center. Profit is not at the center. Or student, for your, you can say, understanding, it's a very important thing is that you remember this two system by one word only. Market system means private. What we can say? Private or individual. Whereas socialist system, it means that it is run through the government. Understood? Now, profit is at the center that we have discussed. Now, we'll discuss another, you can say, points about the market system. So, here we will be having that people invest in those industries. Now, you just see that people invest in those industries where they get or where they found a huge amount of profit. Very simple, they where they found scope of profit. It means very simple, people invest where the people will be investing. For example, if I will be having the capital, it means money. So where should I have to invest? From where I get the huge amount of profit. Very simple thing is that. Now, here what we can say that government does not play any role or economic policy into the market system. So very simple, government not play any role in market system. Now students, very carefully that government are not playing any role in the market system. It means economic decisions are taken by me only. For example, earlier I have given the example, and that example will carry out throughout our session. For example, if I have a company of making or preparing the watch, so what is the price of watch? Who should decide this? Simply owner of the company. Government never ever decide these prices. So we can say that government won't play any role in this market system. Now another topics, or you can say another points about that. Competition play a vital role in market system. Now you just see that competition, you know that competition, right now there is a, you can say, a generation of competition. If I will produce something, same product will be getting in the market. That is called the competition. And due to the competitions, you know that competition play a vital or you can say important role in the market system. For example, if I am producing this watch and I am selling this watch in 2000 rupees, same watch, same you can say quantity or same color or you can say same features of watch, you should be getting in 1000 rupees only. Understood? So that is called competition. So due to competitions, what happened? The production quality is improved. Understood? In market system, that we'll discuss later also. Next one is that owner increase working capacity for getting the more profit. You know that owner of the industry, what they should do? You know that they increase their working capacity. For example, my company or my factory is working for 8 hours only. But if I will be having a huge amount of order, so I increase my, you can say, time durations for getting more benefit. So here owner is free to do the decisions, or you can say owner is having the freedom to take the decision. That is why it is called capitalist system. That is why it is called capitalist system. Now another point about a market system is that thus competition controls the whole market like an invisible hand. Invisible hand. And due to that only, this system is also called free economy. Now you just see students, it's called free economy. Why it is called free economy? You know that? Because here the decision I will be taking, for example, how many watches I have to prepare for a day, per month, this all thing is decided by owner, not as other persons or other party or government should take part in this competition or you can say in these industries. That is why it is called free economy. So students, here we have done the two much question that we can say that right now the market system, this is called market system. You know that? First of all, we write about give the definition about that market system and socialist system. After that, we talk about that. You just see that we talk about that it is called capitalist system. Profit is at the center. These all things we have discussed. Now, and the last one is that people invest in those industries where they found the most scope of profit. Now, student, you just see that we'll discuss about the second questions of today's, and it is too much important. So please watch it carefully. Now students, our second question is that discuss the features of market mechanism system. It means you know that how can we identify this system is market system only. So these are the features that from that we can understand that this system is always, or you can say having a market system, there isn't any involvement of government, it is completely capitalist or free economy. Now first point, we can say that ownership of this system is either individual or private. You know that in this system there is the benefit is that first of all ownership is either individual or private, there isn't an involvement of government. It means economic decisions are taken by the particular persons. Now second one is that profit is at the center in economic activities in market system. Very simple, profit is at the center. Understood? It means what is at the center, you know that whatever the economic activities, for example, I have given the example of my own factories. Okay, if I am producing the watch, okay, so what is at the center of my, what is my main aim or goal? I know that very clear is that profit. Now, next one is that here the consumers get good opportunity of choice. Good opportunity of choice. Now, you know that. Consumers, one more time, look at that. I will make the underline to the main or keyword so you can understand carefully for that. Now, consumers means, for example, I am producing the watch. Understood? So, here, due to you can say competitions, consumers get good opportunity of choice. They will be getting whatever they like, that kind of goods or you can say products may be done in the industries. Now, next one is that government interference is not in this system. It means government not play any role in this system. Next one is that distribution of resources, or you can say distribution of resources or economic decisions is based on profit. I have here already explained that distribution of resources. It means that, for example, my coach is, you can say, self or much in the, you can say, north part of the Gujarat. So distribution of resources in the sense, I will make the units, more units in the north part of the Gujarat. Whereas the watch of my company is not sell in too much in the south, so I will make the less units into the south Gujarat. So due to that distribution of resources as well as this economic decision I taken based on the profit, how much profit I will be getting. Understood? Now next one is that economic decision is taken, or you can say economic decision is are taken while keeping price mechanism, or you can say price in the mind. Understood? Or price mechanism in mind. It means economic decisions are taken while keeping the price in mind. For example, if the watch is sold in 2000 rupees, understood, but same quantity, same quality watch is available in the market of other company is in 1000 rupees, so I must have to be take some decisions regarding that, so I can increase my production system. So this is the features of market system or mechanism system that we have discussed. Now students, our third question is that benefits of market mechanism system. Here in this question is of also 2 marks, so you just have to write benefits of it. Maybe in exam they will ask benefits and limitations together also for 3 marks. Even though for 3 marks they can ask us that write a short note on market system, so in that you need to write about market system features, benefits and limitations. But each of that group you need to write 2 or 3 points, not more than that. Okay, now so here we will be having the benefits of market mechanism system. First one is that economic freedom is protected. Here what happened, you just see that economic freedom in the sense, here I will be free to take the decision, either it may be related to production or resources. I am free to take my own decision. That is why economic freedom is protected. Next one is that resources of production, utilize to greatest extent. I will explain this point. You just see that resources of production. It means what? Whatever the resources I will have used for the productions, that I will be reached to that mark to the quality. For example, if I am preparing, my company is preparing the watch, understood? So best quality of leather, understood? Even the resources of production. It means whatever the instruments, or you can say tools which are used in the production system, that should be used up to the greatest quality. That is why the consumers will be getting the good choice of that things. Or next one is that huge production may be done. It means here I don't have any restrictions. For example, my own industry is that, okay, if I will produce 1 lakh watches or more than 1 lakh watches throughout the day, or you can say throughout the year, no one will restrict me, no one will stop me. That is why you can say huge productions may be done. Now that is the third number. Now our fourth number is that new explorations was going continuously. So there were new explorations means what? For example, if my company is preparing the watch, understood, so every year new additions will be there. For example, first of all we are preparing just a watch, then smart watch, then we can add some other features in that watch. So new explorations is continuously going on. So due to that what happened, development become faster. And the last one is that quality of production or you can say quality of things, that is also become quality of production or things become Now due to competition, what happens? You just see that the quality of the particular product is improved day by day, or you can say year by year. If I will not produce a good quality of watches, then the consumers, or you can say customers, are not satisfied with that product, so they will not purchase it, and ultimately I will be in a loss. Understood? That is why the quality of production of things became improved due to competition. Now students, our fourth question is that discuss limitation of market system. Either limitation they can ask about the disadvantages also. Okay, what are the disadvantages of the market system? Even they can change the name also. Instead of market system, they can ask about that, discuss the limitation of capitalist system. Even though they can ask about that, discuss the limitation of socialist system also. Oh, sorry, you can say free economy also. So these are the limitation of market system. First, you know that we like the market system because each and everything is free. We are free to take the decision. But these are the limitation of the market system. You just see that each one I will make the underline and explain it. Because of keeping a profit in the center of production, of commodities are produced in more quantity, and production of luxurious commodities of basic requirement is neglected or reduced. It means, for example, I give the example and continue that example with going on throughout this session. Here what they are saying, because of keeping the profit is in the center, production commodities are produced in more quantity. It means more quantity, and the production of only luxurious commodities will be done. Luxurious in the sense, these are costliest. Understood? So what happened? The basic requirements are neglected or reduced. It means the company, for example, watch company, the items, or you can say Rado, these all are preparing the, you can say, heaviest watches. So at that time, these basic requirements are neglected or reduced. The second is that because of lack of policy related to role of state, natural resources are wasted. It means here policy related to role of state. It means governments are not playing, or you can say not play any role in this system. So the natural resources are wasted. It means I am using the natural resources without any permissions, and as also they are maybe wasted. Third number, due to lack of knowledge and ignorance about the market, consumers are exploited. Here the consumers are getting good opportunity of choice also, as well as they are exploited also. You know that because due to, for example, if I am preparing the watch which is similar to the, you can say, different companies, understood? But the my watch is of local, you can say, brand. But if I make the copy of it, so here the consumer get confused what is original and what is duplicate. So here the chances of the consumers are getting exploited. Due to centralization of property and income, there is an increase in disparity of income. Disparity of income means what? You can say that property or income of if any one person is increasing only. Why? Because we know that the owner of the industry is either one, or you can say individual. So they increase the amount only. Now the last one is that there is a fear of monopoly, income instability, exploitation of labor, etc. Here main important word is that exploitation of labor. It means what? You know that laborers are working a lot, instead of that they are getting the not enough or sufficient salary. So here we have completed our entire session. Today we have discussed four questions. What is market system? Write a short order market system. Then after we discuss about the features, then benefits, and the last one is limitations. So these all questions is asked in 2 marks. Thank you, students.